Hello guys, welcome back to another video. Unreal Engine 5.6 has just been officially released, and with this release, we are going to be checking out all of the new gameplay templates that come included. Epic has released a bunch of brand new gameplay templates, including a first-person shooter game template, a brand new third-person fighting game template, horror game template, top-down RTS template, action RPG game template, and so much more. So in this video, we'll be checking out each brand new template. I'll be showing you how you can get your hands on these new templates and download them so you can start modifying them to create your own games from scratch. And for those of you who don't know who I am, my name is Smart Polly. I make all sorts of Unreal Engine news and tutorials, so don't forget to leave a like on the video and subscribe, and let's get right into it. Okay, so the first template we'll be checking out is this brand new first-person shooter game template. So as you can see, this brand new first-person shooter game template comes with a variety of different weapons. You can actually see your hands and feet when you're running, but we can pick up a rifle and you can shoot the enemy. It shoots off sort of like this Nerf dart. That's the best way to describe it. You have a couple of these things that you can shoot, these little dummies, and along with that, you have sort of these boost pads that can boost you up onto the different platform. So this template is just loaded with a bunch of different features and gameplay blueprints that you can modify to your liking. So here is another different weapon you can pick up. So you can pick up the pistol. So we have all the different animations, some pistol animations. So we can shoot this little character up there. But what I really like about this is that it's just a simple template. They've actually stripped down a lot of the templates and have optimized them so the package sizes are much smaller. So as you can see, I can boost up here. There's even another different weapon, so we can shoot this guy down here. But there's this grenade launcher that you can pick up, which is the original, you know, OG first-person weapon. So this one just shoots off, you know, this big yellow ball. But as you can see, you can actually switch through the different weapons by clicking Shift. So that will allow you to toggle between your different weapons that you have equipped. You have different physical interactions that you can shoot, like these cubes. And of course, you can just spam the gun. But yeah, these are basically all of the different items that come included in this weapon. It also has a very simple ammunition system. So on the bottom left, you can see how much bullets you have. Another neat thing about this template is I believe it comes with this first person rendering system, or at least some sort of system that allows you to, you know, move your weapon if you try to clip through the wall. So basically, if you try to move into the wall, your gun will not actually clip through the wall. I don't know if this is through the plugin or through the animation, but I think it's a pretty neat feature. Also, you have this automatic door that opens and closes. So yeah, just a lot of neat tools in this template that you can mess around with and build your own first person shooter game on top of it. And before we get into the next template, if you guys genuinely want to learn how to create your own games inside of Unreal Engine 5, I've just launched my Unreal Engine 5 multiplayer survival game course, which features over 270 plus lectures of course content. I show you how to make a complete multiplayer survival game from scratch. We add things like an inventory system, crafting, and harvesting system, and I even show you how to add things like single player and multiplayer support. We create things like a main menu, host game, join game, settings menu, options menu, all of that stuff, and we even cover how to host the game as a listen server or a dedicated server in the cloud. This course is the most comprehensive how to make a game course that you'll find built in Unreal Engine 5, and it is affordable compared to other Unreal Engine courses that charge a fortune of upwards of $400 to $1,000 for a course. That just does not compare to this course in the amount of hours or course content. So just grab the course right now on my website, head over to smartpoly.teachable.com, or click the link in the description below to kickstart your game development journey. And let's get right back into the video. So the next template that we have here is this new third-person combat template. So as you can see here, we can spawn in and you can basically just punch a bunch of the random boxes over here, and also this little physics dummy. The neat thing about it is it comes with all these different animations and particle effects. So we can walk up to this door and smash through these cubes. It even comes with this camera shake effect. So every time you punch something, the movement actually feels very responsive. So here's the little arena. We can go ahead and there's this enemy NPC that spawns in. He has health. We can go ahead and fight him as well. So you can see the different movements. He can actually flee from us. And also we can, you know, kill the character, and he has like ragdoll enabled. So as you can see, he's starting to fight us. We can go ahead and do a couple of combo attacks. So we have a punch, we have a kick, and you can also hit them outside of the arena, which is a pretty neat feature. But you can just see all of the different hit reaction animations. So this is just loaded with a bunch of gameplay logic for you to modify. And also our character is getting hit there, so we're getting damage as well. So you can see the damage system is also working through here. And if you hit the enemy character out of the arena, they also die instantly. So that's just a cool feature. So yeah, this is just a cool, neat fighting game. So all the NPCs, it looks like they are done spawning. So we can hit these boxes. boxes outside the arena. But yeah, that is the third person fighting game template. Let's go ahead and move on to the next template. So next up we have this platformer template. So this is like your traditional platformer game. You have actually a couple of different actions like dash and double jump movements, and also wall jumping. So over here I'm actually trying to figure out the controls, because the jump is actually depending on how long you hold down the space bar. So you can actually jump onto the walls and grab onto that. So it's very similar mechanics from, you know, any sort of platformer game. As you can see, you can jump on the wall to get past this part. Then this next part, you kind of have to dash and jump at the same time. So this was actually super hard. I couldn't actually figure this part out. But after that, you have this area where you can jump and do sort of like this jump back and forth on the wall to get on the very top. But yeah, that is the very simple platformer game mechanics. So it just has this 3D platformer game mechanics with your dash, your double jump, and the different movement controls, as well as this sort of smooth camera movement component that feels very similar to using, you know, a controller and playing it on like a console or something like that. Okay, the next template that I'm going to be checking out is the horror game template. So this is a first person horror game template. So this is actually super simple. Basically, we have a first-person controller where you can look down at your character's hands and see your feet. But along with that, you have sort of like the sprint bar at the very bottom. So if you sprint, it starts to use part of your stamina. So you only have a certain amount of stamina before you have to wait and recharge your sprint. Other than that, you do have a little flashlight attached to the character, so you can go into like this dark room and see part of the area with the flashlight, which you can't really toggle on or off, but you can only see it in, you know, dark rooms. And a lot of the things in here is mainly focused on stuff like the lighting. So this actually uses lumen lighting, and just the atmospherics and everything is really nice. Especially if you look up at the lights, you can see sort of like this dust sort of falling down. Also, another feature with the lights is that some of them are flickering. So you can see here, some of them have sort of like this natural flicker to it, which is pretty cool. But other than that, the horror game template doesn't really feature much other than, you know, automatic doors over here that open and close. There isn't really any jump scares or any enemy AI program into it. So other than that, it's just kind of just a simple walking simulator. So yeah, maybe we'll have to make a future video showing you how to add your own enemy AI that follows you around, and add how to add things like jump scares. But the next template that we have here is the side scroller template. So this is sort of like a 3D side scroller, sort of like, I guess, Super Mario Bros, but in 3D. So we have, you know, some basic actions. We can jump over here. We also have wall jumping. So if you jump off the side of the wall, you can sort of grab onto it and do like a double jump. And over here we have this sort of boost, this platform that boosts you up. You have sort of platforms that the player can pass from below and, you know, grab onto. So over here we're wall jumping and we've made it up to this part. So now we got to jump over here. You also have physical objects that you can push. So this cube, we have to push it in place so that we can move. And also it comes with these little pickups. So these little items, you can create like your own little pickup system. Also in this template, it comes with some AI, very simple AI that will chase the player around. You can actually kill the AI. So we'll have to make another future video showing you how to, you know, jump on the little minion's head there and kill it, sort of like Super Mario Brothers. But as you can see, we have this moving platform. So if the player jumps onto it, it'll move up. And that's pretty much it. There isn't like a windscreen or anything like that. So again, we can just go down through here, through the different platforms, and run through the level again. But that's pretty much it for the 2D side-scrolling template. It definitely does have a lot of potential, so I'll definitely have to make a future video showing how to swap out some of the assets and add some more AI logic into it. All right, so the next template that we have here is this top-down RTS, or real-time strategy template. So as you can see, we can select our unit here and left-click to send them to a different location on the map. And also, there's more different units you can select, so it supports multi-selection of units, so we can select as many as we'd like and send, you know, certain characters to one location where one goes to the other. Another neat feature that comes included in this template is the fact that it has sort of like this cutout view. So if you go into a building that has sort of this roof, you can actually see through the roof. So I think that's like some rendering technique that they're using. And I think they also have the orthographic camera over here, which is also a new feature in Unreal Engine. I think 5.3 is when they introduced it, but it makes use of sort of like this top-down orthographic view of the game. Also, the controls are, you can zoom in and out using your middle mouse button. So it has sort of the, you know, classic RTS game controls. You have your zoom, your select, and your left mouse button click. Other than that, it doesn't really have any interactables other than these physics interactables, and it does have sort of like this emote system. Well, that's pretty much it for the RTS game template. So again, it's just a very simple template that you can use to start building upon it. Maybe you can make some sort of RTS game similar to Age of Empires. It'll just be fun to see what people create with this template. The next template that we have is the top-down action RPG game. Basically, this is sort of like a fast-paced shooter RPG where you can shoot these little yellow balls at the enemies. So these enemy AIs spawn, there's a bunch of them that spawn in and start to chase the player, and you can shoot them with these little yellow balls that you have, you know, infinite ammunition for, and they explode into these little pieces. So I think this is using the chaos physics system for all the destruction, so you can blast them into pieces. And also there are these little pickups. I don't know if you can see them well, but they are these little blue spheres that you can pick up, sort of called like these bombs that you can use, and they explode, and they also slow down time, so it actually slows down the game, does sort of this slow motion, which is pretty neat. And it keeps a score at the very bottom left of the screen, so it shows you what your score is. But the enemy AIs in here actually don't kill you or do any damage to you, so there's no way you can actually lose the game. So again, this is just something that you'll have to build upon, swap out the enemy meshes, and add your own win or lose screen. Maybe you can add more different types of weapons that the player can use to attack the enemies. But honestly, this is a pretty cool template, and I'd love to create some sort of top-down action RPG game with it. Maybe some sort of shooter with it. We'll have to see. Next up are the new racing game templates. So we have this brand new racing game template, as you can see here. So it's like a time trial race circuit. So basically you have to go through the different overlap boxes over here on the track to get to the different checkpoints. So you have sort of like this checkpoint system. You also have these physical cones that you can run into, and they just go flying around crazy. But along with this, you have a timer in the top left. So it keeps like sort of the stopwatch timer, how long it takes for you to complete the circuit. And it also saves your best time. So it shows you what your best time is and how long it takes you to complete the entire circuit. Also, a neat little thing is it comes with this little gear and how fast you're going in the bottom right of the screen. So just pretty neat that this all comes included. And along with that, it comes with these tools in the map itself for the spline, the road spline, and also the cave through the mountain. So just neat that it comes with these extra additional tools you can use. They also modified the default racing template. So they have this off-road template as well, which is basically sort of like this open world map that has a bunch of roads that you can drive around in, and a different sort of Jeep off-road styled vehicle. So it's just pretty neat that they came out with a bunch of other different racing templates and these just different variations. Now, in order to get your hands on these new templates, you'll need to download Unreal Engine 5.6. So you have to go to the Epic Games Launcher and download the latest version of Unreal Engine. And once you go ahead and launch Unreal Engine 5.6, if you head over to the Games tab, you can select the different templates over here. So we have first person, third person, and top down. But to actually add the brand new templates, you need to select the first person template, and under the variant, you can change this from none to arena shooter or survival horror. So you can choose the different variants, or you can leave this as the none, which will give you a, you know, blank first person template. So under the third person template, again, you can choose the variant. We have none, the combat fighting one, the platformer, or the side scroller. And for the top down, we have the strategy or the twin stick, sort of like the RPG, action RPG one. So those are all the brand new templates that come with Unreal Engine 5.6. Let me know what you guys think about these new templates down in the comments down below. And also don't forget to subscribe for more future videos and tutorials, because I'll be taking some of these templates and creating tutorials on how to customize them, swap them out with different assets, and add more logic and behavior to them. So don't forget to leave a like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next one.